This is our pelvis. Okay? Made of four bones. One, two, three sacrum and four coccyx. Okay? We have two hip bones, one hip bone, another hip bone. Okay? Here is the sacrum, here, and this is the coccyx. So, four bones. And how many joints? Four joints. Okay. Where are the joints? Number one, symphysis pubis, between the two hip bones and medially. The two hip bones are not united together on the back, but there is a sacrum in between. So, one sacroiliac, another sacroiliac joint. Okay? So, one sacroiliac joint, another sacroiliac joint. Two joints, third joint, and here. Sacrococcygeal articulations or joint is the fourth. Again, four bones, one bone, another, two. This is the third sacrum, this is fourth coccyx. And all of you can see? Coccyx. Okay? Now, here is one joint, sacroiliac 2, can you write and left? Then here is sacrococcygeal articulation or the joint, and here is symphysis pubis for anterior communication. So, this is basically the hip bone. Hip, the full pelvis we can say. One hip bone, we say this as hip bone. If we have two hip bones together connected only in front without the sacrum and coccyx, this is called hip girdle. Mm-hmm. And all the things is pelvis. Yes. One hip bone is the one hip bone. It is like this in the bone. Slightly angulated, not straight. Yani, if I make the side, it will be easy to understand. Not like straight. This is not horizontal. This is the actual position. So it is making some angle with the horizontal. It is not horizontal. Okay. It is not horizontal like this. It is making some angle like this. Okay. Come. Agree? Okay. Now. Where is the brim? Brim yani the upper margin. So this is the margin. This, not this one. This inlet, this brim, this is pelvic brim. Where is the brim here? Only this line. This line is pelvic brim. Okay? So brim is made by what? Here is the sacrum on the back. All sacrum on the back. Then this is called iliopectineal line from here till here. So iliopectineal line of the ilium bone from here to here, from here to here. On back is the sacrum, and the most prominent part of sacrum is called sacral promontory. So sacral promontory,
where is it?
Here, the most important, the prominent part of sacrum is called promontory.
Protrusion.
Yes, protrusion. So here is the two ala. This is called ala of the sacrum. Here is iliopectineal line, and iliopectineal line along with the upper border of this symphysis makes you the inlet. Again, see, this is the inlet. This line. Okay, inlet is made by sacral promontory and upper margin of symphysis pubis. Good. Okay. Then. Blah, 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 blah. This is same. Same. Trying to show you the inlet. Okay. Above the inlet. Above this margin. This is false pelvis. False pelvis. Huh?
It's
pelvis. Okay. Huh?
It's
false pelvis. False pelvis? Okay, good. This is the pelvic inlet. Okay, above this, all this is false pelvis. It has no anterior boundary.
No
bony. But if I see here, the abdominal muscles are attached here like this. So there is no bony boundary, but there is abdominal wall. Agree? The posterior wall is lumbar vertebra, and on each side iliac fossa with iliacus marker. This is iliac fossa.
with muscle on it here, here, iliacus. Okay, again, this is the pelvic inlet or the brim or the aperture, or there are many names, I will show you. This is the inlet. Above this is false pelvis, made by, the boundary is, there is no anterior bony boundary. It's only with the muscles from here, abdominal muscles. On sides, iliacus, ilium bone, iliac fossa, okay? On the back, lumbar vertebra. So this is the boundary of false pelvis. Then, supports the, what is false pelvis for? Supports the contents, guides the fetus to pass through. True pelvis. Where is the true pelvis? If this is false, anything inside is true pelvis. Lesser pelvis, true pelvis. Anything after the brim inside is true pelvis. Now, if I try to draw here something like on a side view, this is sacrum. Okay? Here is the coccyx, three pieces. Okay? Where is the inlet? About this direction. Because it is not straight. If this was straight, I must make it like this.
Horizontal.
It is not horizontal, it is slightly angled, so I will make this angle. But now, this lower part is straight. Until we get the symphysis pubis somewhere here. So, this is inlet. This is outlet. And this is tube. So, anything above this is false pelvis. False pelvis. Anything behind, below this is true pelvis. And anything behind, below this is outlet or perineum. Again. Wait for perineum. Wait, I'm coming to that.
Again.
This is sacrum, this is coccyx. Okay? Make a concept first. This is the inlet. Where is the inlet? This one. This one is the... Cool. If he's interested, he can come. He's interested to see female pelvis. Okay. This is not straight. This is like this. Agree?
Yeah.
So this is the inlet. Anything above the inlet? False pelvis. Anything below it is the true pelvis. So the true pelvis contains the cavity. Good?
Good.
Okay. This is the outlet. Outlet is where? This is the outlet. This is inlet. This is outlet. Here you can see many bony parts in the outlet. The outlet is not good here. Okay? But when you see outlet in body with the ligaments, it is very nice outlet. Like a diamond, almas.
Where?
This one. Agree?
Yes.
I will come to outlet, wait. But first, again, inlet, false pelvis. Outlet, between the inlet and outlet is true or the cavity. Agree?
Agree.
Good? Then, this outlet is not good as bony, but when it has ligaments, it is very nicely shaped like a diamond almas. So, the true pelvis has an inlet, an outlet, and a cavity. Now clear?
Yes.
Inlet, brim, greater aperture, all names are for inlet. These all names. Pelvic inlet or pelvic brim or greater aperture of pelvis or superior pelvic aperture. Aperture yani opening. A big opening is called aperture. Okay, so all the names and all the boundary is same. Sacral promontory, I told you. Then iliopectineal line, and I told you symphysis pubis, the upper margin. I'm talking of the upper margin. Okay? Then, outlet is diamond shaped. Why I'm saying diamond shaped? See this picture first. Yes, outlet. Outlet. This is the same group, one with upside down. Yani, one picture, this is like this, and that is to show you like this.
With the ligaments.
With the ligaments. This is also with the ligaments. How? See here. See here. This is the diamond shape. Outlet. Here is the coccyx. Three pieces of coccyx. Here is the pubis. Here is ischial tuberosity. When we have bony things, if I have more than bony things along with the ligaments, I have very nice diamond like shape. Add up. Good?
Good, good.
So, what is the outlet made of? Anteriorly is the pubic arch. Okay, what is pubic arch first? This is pubic arch. This thing is pubic arch. Okay? So, anteriorly is the pubic arch in the outlet. Then, posteriorly is the coccyx here. And laterally, ischial tuberosities, one here, one here. Covered with ligaments, like this. Good?
Good.
Again. So, here is arch, pubic arch. Okay? So, when I say of outlet, the boundary of outlet is this arch. Coccyx, tuberosities, and the ligaments.
Sacrospinous,
sacrotuberous ligaments. This is the picture. This is the same, nothing new. I have drawn everything. One sort of pelvis, another sort of pelvis. Brim, outlet. This is inlet, this is outlet. Where is the cavity? Must be here in between. As I draw. This is the same, nothing new. Cavity. Between this and this. So between inlet and outlet is a cavity. And this is like J shape. The cavity. Or the pathway in the cavity. Okay? Shallow anterior and deep on the posterior. Shallow anterior and deep. Small here, big here. Okay. Where is the anterior wall of the cavity? Now I am saying of the pelvic wall, all the wall. Where is the anterior wall? This one. See on this one. This one. Anterior wall, posterior wall, lateral wall here, and lateral wall here. So, nothing new here. Anterior wall is shallow, posterior part of body of the pubis. Just you have to keep this thing in mind and you can draw anything out of it. Posterior wall, sacrum and coccyx, you know. Piriform muscle, I will show. Covering fascia, I will show you. Lateral wall. This is one lateral wall. This is other lateral. Inside. I'm talking of inside. Or anterior wall, posterior wall, one lateral, another lateral. But as we are saying for about the cavity, so it must be, this is the cavity, this is the anterior wall, this is the posterior wall of the cavity, here is one lateral, here is another lateral. Clear? Good. Same thing. Any queries yet?
Yeah.
Good. Same thing, nothing new. Huh. Difference between this and this.
Male or female? The arch.
Yes, see the arch first. Here, the arch is like this. Here, the arch almost is like this. Agree?
Yes.
So remember, when you have arch like this.
Male or female?
Male.
Male?
Female.
Good? So the first thing,
the same one.
When a person is sitting in two boats, here is a person. Here is a person in one boat. Here is another boat.
A person is trying to jump from this board to this board. Anatomy to histology, histology to anatomy. He will go into the middle.
Be careful. No swimming, okay?
The opening. The opening of the jump.
I'm coming to it. But the first thing, the very first thing you come across, male and female, is this one. Arch. So, a narrow arch, male, and wide arch like female. This, female. Number one. Number two. Can you see this broadness?
The inlet.
And this is less.
Yeah.
Inlet. If I see inside, if I see inside, the cavity is more
big,
roomy, vast. And here, it is short. Narrow.
No,
not possible. Yes. Nothing is head to come out. Because all these adaptations are why? Because the head of the baby is the biggest thing to pass through. So once it is crossed, everything is crossed. So this is adaptation.
Then also the angle of the
holes. The holes here.
Holes. Yes. The holes have different shape.
No.
Obturator foramen. These are called obturator foramen. I will bring you a description. Then, any other difference?
Yeah,
you feel
the iliac.
Through bones
heavier,
of the same
the
age, same weight.
Heavier.
The female is lighter. Even big, still lighter. And the male must be heavier because of big and strong bones.
There is also the...
But they should be of equal size, age, blah, blah, blah.
The angle of the sacrum of obsidio.
The angles of the sacrum in male is like this, more. If this is more like in females, the head will stuck. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the sacrum and the coccyx slightly backward. Not true backward like this, but it is more back than the male one. If the male is like this, the female is like this.
So not according to this.
The ischial tuberosities, these two big things. In male are usually like this inside, and in females just like here. But the biggest difference is this thing for differentiation exam.
Open it.
And see the cavity or the inlet is big like and inlet is small. Find the difference? Good. Now see this table. Everything I told you is here. Pelvic, false pelvis, shallow in deep. Inlet. Oval and heart shape. Don't try to find heart like atrium and ventricles. It is heart like this. Here by heart. Okay. Cavity is more vase, roomier, and here is narrow. So all the differences are more detailed.
The major one is the arch.
No, yes. The most one. Striking. Once you are in exam striking like this, go for it. This is the picture. Another picture showing you all the differences also. Inlet is like this. In females, and outlet is so big. As compared to male, the cavity is not like shallow in the tip. It's vase, roomy, wider here. And same, the arch I told you to remember this like
7
and
you.
This like
7.
So
and
this is male pelvis, this is female. Agree, sir?
Yeah. Good.
All differences once again. Differences once again. So you must not forget the differences. Okay. If this is open like this, anything cannot be held, it will fall down. Uterus and vagina and blah 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 blah, everything will go out. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made one diaphragm here to hold everything on it. Both. All. This is the level. Holding everything at the proper place. This is called pelvic diaphragm.
Made of muscles?
Made of muscles. Made of muscles. Skeletal muscles in my control. Okay. Now, I have taught you for perineum. Okay. So, come now, where is the perineum? Inside the cavity. Here is the cavity. From here till here is the cavity. Inside the cavity, there is a diaphragm like this. Good. Above the diaphragm is pelvis. Below the diaphragm is perineum. Good now?
So it's supposed to be at the margin.
Maybe, yes. Yani, maybe like this even. Anything above this diaphragm is pelvis. Anything below this
perineum.
Is perineum. Okay?
So why you are lagging behind today? Want to irritate me or what? Or really not understanding? Come in front if you are not listening. Please, bring your chair here. Okay?
Anything above the diaphragm, pelvic muscles is pelvis. And anything below is perineum.
Forget about the perineum here because you have separate lab and separate everything for perineum.
So fix on the pelvis first. So we are only here with inlet, outlet,
cavity.
And the cavity. The differences you know now.
Yes.
Heavy, blah, 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 blah.
Done.
And now I'm coming to the diaphragm. This is pelvic diaphragm. How it is attached here? It is attached here like this. So same picture you are seeing here. Same sort of.
Some.
Okay, same sort of. Here is the sacrum.
So here is the sacrum.
Here is the symphysis tubus. Here is the symphysis tubus. So try to understand here. Both have. Male and female, they both have a pelvic diaphragm. Where is this diaphragm? You know the location now. And it is a thing like this. Deficient here. Not mojood here.
Yeah, for the sexual organs.
Okay? Why? Because the vagina has to cross in females. The urethra in males and females both have to cross. So there is an opening for this. So it is deficient anteriorly. So this is anterior, the posterior. Okay? And if I take this like, here is somewhere rectum or anal canal, which is not crossing from here, it has to cross from the center. Like it is crossing here. Or here. Okay? So, there is one fibromuscular band here, one fibromuscular band here. Why? The muscle is arising from the bony parts here. Here is the coccyx. Agree? Here is symphysis pubis. Good? Here is the origin where this muscle should go. So half of the muscle coming from here. Half of the muscle group coming from here, and they some of the fiber are inserted here in this pelvic area or body or fibromuscular structure, and the remaining are going here to be inserted, leaving the space for vagina and urethra and blah 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 for anterior part. This rectum has to be in the center like this.
Has to be.
Where? Not here. This is rectum gaffi.
Okay.
Not here. We have removed. Okay. Now, this whole structure is composed of two muscles. See this. Can you see two color differences?
Yes.
When you will come near, I can show you. So, let me draw it like this to make the life easier. Like this, as I can hold it like good. Okay? Make it again. Okay? For vagina and urethra, here is rectum, here is one fibromuscular cord, another fibromuscular cord, here is sacrum, coccyx. Like this now. So, here is one muscle group, like here, and it is made of, this is the midline. This is one muscle group, another muscle. The big one here is called two muscles. Levator ani and coccygeus. This is levator ani and this is coccygeus. Again, here is levator ani and here is coccygeus. we are not here to defend the insertions, origins, blah blah blah, because your objective says enumerate, so name them. But still I have written the origins and insertions, everything on the sheet. If you wish to understand, or if you have difficulty in understanding how or where, so you can find. Okay. So it is composed of two muscles here, levator and eye, this one, and coccygeus, this one, a small one. Again, the levator and eye and coccygeus are further divided into simpler forms. See, this is the view from inferior side. Levator and eye muscles have three types of fibers: anterior fibers, middle fibers, and posterior fibers. So where are these fibers? Anterior fiber, middle fiber, and posterior fiber. Middle and posterior. But don't go into detail. Where, why, how. Forget it. So remember, the diaphragm is made of two muscles. Levator and eye and coccygeus. Levator and eye has three parts. Anterior fibers, middle fiber, posterior fiber. What they are doing? The anterior fiber are also called levator prostatae. Levator yani?
Yep.
To elevate prostate or sphincter vagina in males or in females. So, levator prostate will hold your prostate, and sphincter vagina in females will act as a sphincter of the vagina. So, these are the anterior fibers of levator and eye muscles. This is? No, that is not a muscular structure. That is truly a mucosal structure. Try it. Intermediate fibers. Intermediate fibers are again of two types, and posterior fibers are again of two types. Sphincter does not mean like the smooth muscles of the vagina and the peripheral muscles of this levator and eye are there to help the contraction of the vagina. The normal vaginal wall is not open. It is closed. So many of these factors are there to close, to keep the wall closed. And it is not closed from side to side. It is closed from anterior to posterior. Okay? So it is closed from anterior to posterior. Good. Then, the second, okay, this is the nerve supply of levator and eye. Peroneal branch, S4 and protendon. What is the action? What is the action of this thing?
Maintenance the
supporting. So support and maintain pelvic viscera in their positions. Number one, they are placed here. Number one, release the rise of intrapelvic pressure. How? When you are coughing, when you are straining in the toilet, what is happening? The abdominal pressure is going anteriorly, cannot go back of bones and make it down. Try to make the pelvic diaphragm down. But this is the strength of the muscles which push it up and keeps everything at the place. If the muscle is weak, what will happen? And that is called prolapse of the rectum. The rectum coming out of it. The prolapse of vagina coming out of it. Hernia, forget about hernia here. Hernia is for abdominal wall, not the diaphragm. This is called rectal prolapse, very good. And that is called vaginal prolapse, when the vagina or the rectum is getting out of it. In old females, they do not tell you that this is happening. But many of them have rectal and vaginal prolapses together. They are smelly and they are having discharges and they are going to the doctors off and on. If they are not so obvious to come down, at least the ligaments are weak enough because of age, because of multiparity, yani multiple children, and different other bony and ligamentous reasons or connective tissue reasons, they can not just go outside like this hanging, but they can leave their position. Understand? Act as sphincter of anorectal junction and vagina. Coccygeus muscle, the back one, this one. Coccygeus muscle. Small muscle. Nerve supply branches from S4 and S5 acts and supports levator and eye to help everything. Yani the same function. So both of them, levator and eye and coccygeus, are working together for all these functions, which I told you. Good, thank you. You saved my life. Same picture? Huh. various fibers, so in both genders, various fibers you can see here. Back, this anterior.
So,
if I say the anterior part, the middle part, the posterior part, and the posterior, you can differentiate. Okay?
Thank you. Same. Good. Piriformis. This was, this thing is where located?
Floor of the pelvis.
Agree?
So we have decided there is anterior boundary, there are posterior boundary, bony. I have given you bony things. There is two lateral bony boundaries, and there is a floor without bone make of this pelvic diaphragm. Good? Now, this is the posterior wall. Piriformis. Where is piriformis? Where is the posterior wall bony? Posterior bony wall is sacrum. So from the sides of sacrum here and sides of sacrum here, two piriform muscles are coming and they are leaving the pelvis and going to femur here. Going to femur here. Greater propeller. Next. Sure. See this one. Okay? This is basically arising from here. This inside the pelvis. Can you see from here?
Yes.
And going back out here.
To the greater trochanter.
Yes, to the greater trochanter, like this. This is piriformis, making the posterior boundary muscular wall of the pelvis. So, when you have bony pelvis boundaries, name the bones. When they ask in exam, make the muscular also, so write the muscle on the posterior wall is piriformis. And similarly, on the sides, lateral, is obturator internus, and you can see the muscle here. Obturator internus.
Mm.
This one. Covering the obturator foramen. Mm. Covering the obturator foramen. Good?
Mm.
Coming to obturator internus. Where is obturator internus? This is obturator foramen. And obturator internus is covering the whole muscle and leaving out again for greater trochanter like this. The green one is obturator internus. Both of them, piriformis, go back. Piriformis and both of them, obturator, are lateral rotators of hip.
Yes.
How? Where is, this is my hip.
Yeah.
Flexion, extension, abduction, adduction, lateral. So lateral rotation is becoming from here. This. So these two are lateral rotators. Agree now?
Agree.
Understand? Next. Same picture. Next. Huh. Sacrospinous and sacrotuberous ligament. Name are explanations. Sacrotuberous. Sacro, yani from sacrum to the ischial tuberosity. Sacrospinous from sacrum to ischial spine. Sacrospinous is spine. Sacrotuberous is tuberosity. They are very big, strong ligaments which are giving, if you see this properly, this thing. This is greater sciatic notch and lesser sciatic notch. The bad old days. Remembering the muscles, skeletal jerks of muscles. Here is greater sciatic notch. Here is lesser sciatic notch. Now, see here. You cannot appreciate notches, but two foramens. One here and one here.
Yeah.
Agree?
Yes.
So big one, greater sciatic foramen. Lesser one, lesser sciatic foramen. Now,
what are the ligaments?
Yes, go down. See here. This was notch previously. Now, sacrotuberous ligament and this is spine. Sacrospinous ligament. So, here is one foramen, here is another foramen. Greater sciatic, greater foramen, lesser sciatic foramen. So there are many structures you know from your musculoskeletal, you forget, alhamdulillah, come out of this. Same. Yes. This is showing you sacrotuberous. Here is the sacrospinous. Here I remove the sacrotuberous, only sacrospinous is moving. Okay. Again, the same ligaments in full form. Fascia of the pelvis. Very easy. This is the inductivity. Consider here. I cannot hold the two things together. Okay. Here is, for example, uterus. like this. Okay?
You want to
open? No, no, it's okay. Here is the uterus. Okay? On the floor. So, the uterus and all the organs are covered with fascia, very thin connective tissue. And connective tissue is also going towards the walls. So, this is called visceral fascia, this is called parietal fascia. The one which is covering the wall is called parietal fascia. The one which is covering the organs is visceral fascia. But they are not two fascia. How? This is, for example, is the uterus. Here is the cavity. Okay? So here fascia only on the uterus is called visceral, for example. And this is going here on the anterior wall, so it is becoming parietal. Here it's going to posterior wall, so parietal. So here it's going to lateral wall here and lateral wall here on two sides. So this is the same fascia covering all the walls, and but depending upon if this is mojood on the uterus, so it is, or any other, this is visceral, and if this is on the wall, we say this is parietal. So it means there is first bone, then muscles, and then is the fascia. So
what about peroneum?
That's peritoneum. This is peritoneum. Again, so if I make the cavity here, like for example, I have to make a very big space for the cavity. See these three different colors, I can manage if possible. This is the cavity of the pelvis. I'm seeing from above like this. This is called panoramic view. Panoramic view is from seeing from above. Okay. So, seeing from above, here is anterior, here is posterior. The first is the bony wall. The bone. Here is again the bony wall. Bone. Good?
Good.
Second is the muscle layer. Here, anterior and posterior. Maybe here piriformis, maybe here obturator, maybe here piriformis, obturator. So, this is the muscle wall. Still inside is the facial wall. Still inside is the peritoneum. Okay? This is, I am looking from top like this. And if I look from side, it will appear like this. This is the peritoneum here, going to rectum, going up here and going back. Similarly, here in female, going onto the uterus, bladder, and going upward. Can you appreciate two lines here, one thick in between is the fascia and above is the peritoneum. Good?
Good.
Got the idea?
Yes.
Next year. Khalas, pelvimetry. What is pelvimetry? Initial days we used to measure the length of the pelvis. Yani, we have to measure, go another picture. We have to measure anterior, posterior, transverse and oblique.
The brim
and the cavity also. Why? Because if the cavity is small in females, it's very difficult
for the
labor.
Baby.
That is called difficult labor. And the term used is dystocia.
How do we
do it? Nowadays on x-rays and previously on examination. Okay? So nowadays on x-rays and CTs and blah 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 is mojood. So pelvimetry is no more in use here. Or anywhere. Next. But for your help, I have given you some of the numbers. If someone is interested, like Dr. Hindavi, can jump in and he can read it. Okay, next. This is four types of female pelvis. Now, inside female pelvis, there may be varieties. This is, we should not say them abnormal.
Variation.
We should not say variation, so I put varieties. Okay. Some of the books say abnormal, but I may not. Gynocoid is typical pelvis, which we have, which I discussed is truly gynocoid pelvis. So keeping this in mind as control, see this one.
Heart shape,
more like male.
Yes.
Okay. Then, more like flat, anterior posterior, and more oblong. Okay. This is typical animal, this is typical female, this is typical male, but if this is typical.
All are.
But some, yes, all of these are females. The worst is this one, and alhamdulillah, this is rare, 2% only. And this is absolutely, we are discussing as classical, so more of them are. I think. One thing is fractures of the pelvis. There's not only the beauty in pelvis, there are fractures also. Okay? The fractured pelvis is a very bad thing. Why?
Nerves.
Because the pelvis is a ring-like structure.
Here.
The whole ring-like structure. And if there is fracture in the ring on one side, it is stable. If I have injury from here and I hit the wall again, so injury one here, so one fracture is here and one is here. That is the worst thing. Because the ring is broken and everything is expanding now. So it's very painful and bad. These are the common signs. May you be knowing, it's just better to know sometime in taking a state exam or something.
I think it's
good. Good? Something? Come.